Friends, today we will understand Chapter 16, Heredity and Variation, Module 2. In the previous module, we have studied about inheritance, heredity characteristics and their appearance. In this module, we will study about deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, gene, and ribonucleic acid, that is RNA. Students, first let us understand what is DNA. DNA is a molecule that contains all of an organism's genetic material and is therefore responsible for heredity. I repeat, DNA is a molecule that contains all of an organism's genetic material and is therefore responsible for heredity. A strand of DNA, this is a strand of DNA, contains many genes, all of which code for proteins. Each of these proteins has a different function in a cell. Students, chromosomes are mainly made up of DNA. DNA was discovered by the Swiss biochemist Friedrich Miescher in 1869. While studying white blood cells. Initially, this acid was reported to be only in the nucleus of cells. Hence, it was named nucleic acid. However, it was later realized that it is present in other parts of the cell too. Students, molecules of DNA are present in all organisms from virus and bacteria to humans. I repeat, molecules of DNA are present in all organisms from viruses and bacteria to human beings. These molecules control the functioning, growth, and division, that is reproduction of the cell, and are therefore called master molecules. I repeat, these molecules control the functioning, growth, and division, that is reproduction of the cell, and are therefore called master molecules. Students, the structure of DNA molecule is the same in all organisms. In 1957, Watson and Crick produced a model of the DNA molecule. I repeat, in 1957, Watson and Crick produced a model of the DNA molecule. As per this model, two parallel threads of nucleotides are coiled around each other. I repeat, as per this model, two parallel threads of nucleotides are coiled around each other. As you can see here, children, this arrangement is called double helix. This arrangement is called a double helix, This structure can be compared with a coil and flexible ladder. Students, each strand in the molecule of DNA is made up of many small molecules known as nucleotides. I repeat, each strand in the molecule of DNA is made up of many small molecules known as nucleotides.
Students, there are four types of nitrogenous bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. I repeat, there are four types of nitrogenous bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Students, adenine and guanine are called purines, while cytosine and thymine are called pyrimidines. I repeat, adenine and guanine are called purines, while cytosine and thymine are called pyrimidines. Also, in the structure of nucleotide, a molecule of a nitrogenous base and phosphoric acid are each joined to a molecule of sugar. I repeat, in the structure of the nucleotide, a molecule of a nitrogenous base and phosphoric acid are each joined to a molecule of sugar.
As there are four types of nitrogenous bases, nucleotides also are of four types. Nucleotides are arranged like a chain in the molecule of DNA. The two threads of the DNA molecule are comparable to the two rails of a ladder, and each rail is made up of alternately joined molecules of sugar and phosphoric acid. Each rung of the ladder is a pair of nitrogenous bases joined by hydrogen bond. Students, adenine always pairs with thymine. As you can see here, children, adenine always pairs with thymine, and cytosine always pairs with guanine. As you can observe here, I repeat, adenine always pairs with thymine, and cytosine always pairs with guanine. Now, next we will understand about gene. Students, each chromosome is made up of a single DNA molecule. I repeat, each chromosome is made up of a single DNA molecule. Segments of the DNA molecule are called genes. I repeat, segments of the DNA molecule are called genes. Due to variety in the sequence of nucleotides, different kinds of genes are formed. These genes are arranged in a line. I repeat, due to variety in the sequence of nucleotides, different kinds of genes are formed. These genes are arranged in a line. Genes control the structure and function of the cells and of the body. Also, they transmit the hereditary characteristics from parents to offspring. Hence, they are said to be the functional units of heredity. That is why many similarities are seen between parents and their offspring. Information about protein synthesis is stored in genes. I repeat, information about protein synthesis is stored in genes. Students, so let us see what is DNA fingerprinting. The sequence of genes in the DNA of a person is identified. I repeat, the sequence of the genes in the DNA of a person, that is the genome of the person, is identified. DNA fingerprinting is useful to identify the lineage and to identify criminals because it is unique to every person. I repeat, DNA fingerprinting is useful to identify the lineage and to identify criminals because it is unique to every person. Now next, we will understand about states of technology. In 1990, the Human Genome Project was together undertaken by all geneticists of the world. In June 2000, scientists of this project and Celera Genomics Corporation, that is a private industry in USA, collectively announced the discovery of complete DNA sequence of the human genome. Depending upon the findings of this project, scientists confirmed that the number of genes in the human genome is about 20,000 to 30,000. I repeat, depending upon the findings of this project, scientists confirmed that the number of genes in the human genome is about 20,000 to 30,000. Later, scientists discovered the genomic sequence of many microorganisms. Students, due to research in genomics, disease causing genes can be identified. If disease causing genes are identified, genetic diseases can be diagnosed and properly treated. I repeat, due to research in genomics, disease-causing genes can be identified. If disease-causing genes can be identified, genetic diseases can be diagnosed and properly treated. Now next, we will understand about ribonucleic acid, that is RNA. Students, RNA is the second important nucleic acid of the cell. RNA is made up of ribose sugar, phosphate molecules, and four types of nitrogenous bases, that is adenine, guanine, cytosine, and uracil. I repeat, RNA is made made up of ribose sugar, phosphate molecules and four types of nitrogenous bases, adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. The nucleotide, that is the smallest unit of the chain of the RNA molecule, is formed by combination of ribose sugar, phosphate molecule and one of the nitrogenous bases. I repeat, the nucleotide, that is the smallest unit of the chain of the RNA molecule, is formed by combination of ribose sugar, phosphate molecule and one of the nitrogenous bases. Large number of nucleotides are bonded together to form the macromolecule of RNA. I repeat, large number of nucleotides are bonded together to form the macromolecule of RNA. According to function, there are three types of RNA: ribosomal RNA, that is rRNA, then messenger RNA, that is mRNA, and transfer RNA, that is tRNA. Let us understand one by one. First is ribosomal RNA, that is rRNA. Students, the molecule of RNA, which is a component of ribosome organelle, is called ribosomal RNA. Ribosomes perform the function of protein synthesis. I repeat, the molecule of RNA, which is a component of the ribosome organelle, is called ribosomal RNA. Ribosomes perform the function of protein synthesis. Next is messenger RNA. Students, that is mRNA. The RNA molecule that carries the information of protein synthesis from genes, that is DNA chain, in the cell nucleus to ribosomes in the cytoplasm, which produce the proteins, is called messenger RNA, that is mRNA. I repeat, the RNA molecule that carries the information of protein synthesis from genes, that is DNA chain, in the cell nucleus to ribosomes in the cytoplasm, which produce the proteins, is called messenger RNA. And last is transfer RNA, that is tRNA. The RNA molecule, which according to the message of the mRNA carries the amino acid up to the ribosomes, is called transfer RNA. I repeat, the RNA molecule, which according to the message of the mRNA carries the amino acid up to the ribosomes, is called transfer RNA. Now let us see points to remember. A strand in the molecule of DNA is made up of many small molecules known as nucleotide. Segments of DNA molecule are called gene. DNA fingerprinting is useful to identify the lineage and to identify criminals because it is unique to every person. Large number of nucleotides are bonded together to form the macromolecule of RNA. I repeat, each strand in the molecule of DNA is made up of many small molecules known as nucleotide. Segments of the DNA molecule are called gene. DNA fingerprinting is useful to identify the lineage and to identify criminals because it is unique to every person. Large number of nucleotides are bonded together to form the macromolecule of RNA. There is a short homework for you. Define gene. Explain the different types of RNA. What do you mean by DNA fingerprinting? Draw a neat and labeled diagram of DNA. Thank you.